Hello children, today I am starting multiplication of integers, okay, and that is exercise 1.3. So for starting, before starting, some rules are there how to multiply 2 or 3 or 4 integers, okay. So likewise we have done addition and subtraction. In multiplication also we will take sign along with the numericals value, okay, then only we will get the answer. Like see here, if two integers are there, both are positive, okay, then your answer will come in positive. If two integers are here and both are negative, then your answer will be in positive. But if one is negative and other one is positive, means both have different sign, then your answer will come in negative sign. Okay, this was of two integers. Likewise for three integers, if all signs are same, that are minus, then your answer will come in minus. Why? Minus minus will be plus. You see, minus minus will be plus. So, and then plus into minus, that will give you negative sign. So, here it is. Means if there are three negative numbers, then your answer will be negative. But if there are three positive numbers, your answer will be in positive. Okay. So generalizing all these, we come to a conclusion that if negative, okay, negative sign to the power n. See here, okay, it is given negative sign to the power n. If this n is even, means if it is 2, 4, 6 and 8, then your answer will be always in positive, okay. But if this n is odd, your answer will come in negative, okay. So memorize these rule, okay. If two or more than integers are there and all integers have negative sign, okay, there are an even number of integers and all have negative sign, then your answer will come in positive, okay. And if all the negative integers are there, okay, and all number of integers are odd, okay, then you will get negative sign. So this is the important rule for multiplication of integers, okay. With the help of these, we are starting our new exercise 1.3, okay. So see here, I am doing some of the question, rest of the question do it by yourself, that will be for your practice purpose, okay. Some of the question I am explaining. See here, first one is find products. You have to find the product of these. So see here, first one number is positive and other number is negative, okay, means positive into negative, we have discussed it will come negative, means our answer will come in negative. And you multiply 35 into 7, okay, that will come 245. So our answer for 7 into minus 35 will be with minus sign 245. Clear? Now see here, minus 13 into 15, okay. So minus 13 into 15, both have similar sign, means negative sign. So we know that if both have negative sign, see here, minus 1 to the power 2, it is two negative numbers are there, na? To the power 2, so the number power is all even. So our answer will be positive. So multiply 13 into 15, you will get 195. Your answer will be plus 195. Clear? Similarly, see here, minus, that means minus to the power 3. 3 negative integers are there, na? So power is what? Odd. Okay. Then our answer will come in negative. We know that if power is odd, then our answer will always in negative. So by Multiplying this all, we get minus 1, 3, 2, 0. First of all, multiply 12 into 11. Okay, what you will get? 12 means 132. And then 132 into 10, that will give you 1, 3, 2, 0. So, your answer will be minus 1,320. Now, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. How many negative integers are there? There are 4 negative integers. So, power is what? Even. Hence, our answer will come in positive. So, our answer will be 6 into 3, 18, 2 into 1, 2. Okay. So, our answer will be 36. It will be plus because the power of negative sign is even. Clear? I think this question is clear to all. Now, and what about if I multiply with 0? If integers are multiplied with 0, minus 13 into 0, it will come 0 only. That is the same rule. Okay? No need for negative or positive sign because 0 is neither a negative number nor a positive number. Okay. So now, next question is verify the following. See here, one equation is given and you have to prove that both sides are equal. So what we will do? First of all, we will find LHS, left hand side, and then we will find right hand side. Okay, if both are equal, that means our equation is correct. Okay, so now starting for LHS, it is 37 into 6 plus minus 3, that means 6 minus 3. It equals to 37 into 6 minus 3, that is 3. Okay, hence our answer will be 1, 1, 1. Similarly, come on right hand side. It is 37 into 6 and 37 into minus 3. So 37 into 6, both are positive. Our answer will be positive, that is 2. 2, 2. Now, see here, plus positive, negative. So, our answer will be negative. So, your answer will be minus 1, 1, 1. So, 222 minus 1, 1, 1. That will give you 1, 1, 1. See, left hand side is equals to RHS, right hand side. Hence, this equation is verified. Okay. So, clear how you have to do this? For verification, first of all, you will find LHS, then you will find RHS. And both you will equate. That will give you the verification of this equation. Okay. Now, let's do like this. This question only. LHS. First of all, find LHS. Minus 21, it will be minus plus into minus. Okay, positive into negative, that is equals to negative. So, minus 21 into minus minus, both signs are same. So, what we will do? Addition. Okay, and if we are doing addition, then it will come 10 and the sign will be negative. So, it will be 210. Why? Because both have same sign, minus and minus. So, our answer will be positive. Similarly, come on right hand side. It is 21 into minus 6 plus minus 21 into minus 4. Okay. So, minus minus plus. And it will come 126. Similarly here, minus minus will be plus. and it will come 84. Adding both, we will get 210. Hence, LHS is equals to RHS. Clear? How you have to verify? First of all, find LHS, then RHS. Okay? So, question number 1 and 2 are clear to all of you. Now, come to question number 3. What is question number 3? Using suitable property, evaluate the following. You know the properties, na? Associative law, distributive law, commutative law. These are all the properties of multiplication, okay? That property you have to use here and you have to find the value of this. Okay. Now, coming to first one, that is -8 into 53 into -125. We will use here using associative property. Okay. So, what is associative property? Multiplying with this and this and then multiplying it with this. Okay. That will be equals to multiplying this and this. Okay. Means first of all we will multiply 8 into -125 and what will come, then we will multiply it with 53. That will be the same for 8 into 53 into -125. So 8 into -125 into 53. By multiplying this both, we will get minus of 1000. Why minus? Because one is positive and second one is negative. So our answer will be negative and multiplied with 53. So minus into minus. Now it is easy to multiply 53 with 1000. So our answer will be -53,000. Okay. Now it is easier now. Why? Because first of all we have multiplied this and it is 1000 and we know that by multiplication with 10, 100, 1000 it is easier for us. Instead of multiplying with 8 into 53 and then product will come, that product you will multiply in -125, that will give you lots of trouble. So for generalizing that, we will do like this, okay, using associative property. So our answer is -53,000. Similarly, we will do here. See here, we will do associative property in this also. Okay, so how we will do? Right now, using associative property, what we will get? First of all, we will multiply 15 into -10. It is one bracket. And another bracket is -25 into -4. Okay. Why we have done this? Multiplying with 10, it is easier for us. And we know that 25 into 4, it comes 100. Okay. So, it will come minus plus minus, it will be -150 and it is minus minus, it is plus, so it will come 100. So what our answer will be? 15,000. It is easier now. First we are multiplying, we have divided both these equation into two part. 15 into -10 first we will do, -25 into -4 we will do, then their product will be multiplied with each other. Okay, more questions are here there in this question number 3. Okay, try to solve that with different properties. Now I am coming to this one. What about this? -47 into 102. If we will directly multiply, then we can do multiplication, but it will take time. Okay. But if we will use distribution law of multiplication, you know that we can write now 102 into 100 plus 2. We can write now 102 equals to 100 plus 2. We can write. So, using distributive law of addition. Okay, what it will come? First of all, we will multiply minus 47 into 100. Okay, and then minus 47 will be multiplied in 2. Okay, means directly 100 plus 2 is multiplied by minus 47. You can write like this also using distributive law of addition. Now it is easier. It will be minus 4700 plus 47 into 2 minus it is. So it will come minus 94. So your answer will be minus 47 plus into minus. It will be minus. Minus minus is plus. So we will add minus 4794. That will be our answer. Okay. So you see this large multiplication we have done in only a second. Okay. So for solving these type of question, you can use your distributive law of addition. Clear? Rest of the question, try to do by your own. It will be your practice. Okay. Now, some word problems are there. First one is, it is given a certain freezing process requires that room temperature be lowered from 32 degrees centigrade at the rate of 5 degrees centigrade every hour. Okay, what will be the room temperature 8 hours after the freezing process begins? Means for certain freezing process, what it should require? That room temperature should be lowered from 32 degrees centigrade at 5 degrees centigrade per hour. Means at every hour, 5 degrees centigrade, it is lowering the temperature. Okay. The temperature is getting lower at the rate of 5 degrees centigrade per hour. So after 8 hours, what will be your temperature? For finding this, first of all, we will find in 8 hours, how many temperature it will be lowered. Okay, means in 1 hour, see here, in 1 hour it is lowered by 5 degrees centigrade. Okay, then in 8 hour it will be lowered by how much? 8 into 5 na? That is simple rule. For 1 hour 5 degrees centigrade, then for 8 hour it will be 8 into 5. Means 45 degrees centigrade. Means after 8 hour 45 degree centigrade temperature is lowered. Okay. So now it is asking what will be the room temperature 8 hours. Okay. Means after 8 hours this much of temperature is lowered. So in beginning our temperature was 32 degree centigrade. Now at last it is 45 degree centigrade. Clear now? Sorry, it is 40. Okay, by mistake it is written 85, so 40. So after 8 hour 40 degree centigrade will be lower. So 32 degree centigrade minus 40 degree centigrade. So 32 degree centigrade minus 40 degree centigrade, it will be equals to minus of 8 degree centigrade now. Why? Because 40 is greater than 32 and we will take the sign of larger one, that is negative. Means after 8 hours the temperature of the room will be minus 8 degree centigrade. Okay, means every hour it is lowering by 5 degree centigrade, so after 8 hours it will be lowered by 40 degree centigrade. So in starting it was 32 degree centigrade and at last, means after 8 hours it is 40 degree centigrade. So the temperature is equals to initial minus final. Okay, so that is minus 8 degree centigrade. Clear? That was your question. You can write this in numerical problems. Okay, write the statement also and then try to write this question. Now, next one is, in a class test containing 10 questions, 5 marks are awarded for every correct answer and 2 marks are deducted for every incorrect answer and 0 for questions non-adapted. First of all, we will write, okay, for correct answer, we are getting 2 marks. No, 5 marks it is. We are getting 5 marks. For wrong answer, 2 marks are deducted, means we are getting negative numbers, minus 2. And for not attempted, we are getting 0. Okay, now these are the conditions through which you have to solve the questions. Okay, now see, question number 1. In this question, 3 parts are there. You have to find, first of all, Rohit score. Okay. So, it is saying, first one, Rohit gets 4 correct and 6 incorrect answers. Means, how many correct answers are there? 4. So, he will get 4 into 5 marks. That is 20. Means, for 4 correct answer, he will get 20 marks. Then, 6 incorrect answers are there. Okay. How many incorrect answers are there? 6. So, see here, for incorrect answer, we will multiply it with minus 2. For one incorrect answer, he will get minus 2. So, for 6, he will get 6 into minus 2. That is equals to minus of 12. What is his score now? So, what will be his score? We will add both. So, his score will be equals to 20 plus of minus 12. Plus into minus, that will be minus. So, his score will be 8. Clear? Clear? How we have done this? Means, first of all, find the marks for correct answer, then marks for wrong answer. Then add both of them, you will get the total score. Now, second one, for Seema. Gets 5 correct and 5 incorrect answer. Okay, how many correct answers are there? 5. So, her marks for correct answer is 25. How many incorrect answers? 5 incorrect answers are there. So, 5 into minus 2. That will be her deducted for wrong answer. That will be minus 10. So, score will be 25. Plus of minus 10 means 25 minus 10, that is 50. Clear? Now third one I am doing here. Ritu attempted 7 questions, means total attempted question are 7 questions she had attempted and gets only 2 correct answers. Okay, for 2 correct answers, he will get how much? 2 into 5, that is 10 marks. 10 marks are for correct answer. But she has attempted how much questions? 7 questions. Okay. For attempted 7 questions. So, Ritu's award for attempting 7 questions, it will be 7 question attempted one. Is equals to 7. Total questions she has done 7. And out of 7, only 2 are correct. Okay. Means rest of the questions are wrong now. It means what? In 7 questions, she has attempted 7 questions. But in 7 questions, only 2 are correct. okay, and rest of the questions are wrong. So wrong number of questions are how much? 7 minus 2, that is equals to 5. So score for wrong questions will be 5 into minus 2, that will be equals to how much? Minus of 10. Clear now? Means he's saying Ritu attempted 7 questions and gets only 2 correct answer. Means total questions she had attempted 7, but out of 7 only 2 is correct, so rest of should be incorrect now. So correct one we have get 10 marks, and for incorrect, that is 5 question, we are getting minus 10. So score will be equals to how much? 10 plus of 10, that means she has scored 0. Clear? I think all of you are clear with this questions. Any problem to anyone? First of all, try to read the questions and then see the solution. You will get the right one. Okay, you will get how we have solved this questions. Now, see here, this question is same which we have done earlier. Okay. But here in one question, two conditions are given. Given, find a pair of integers whose product is minus 15 and whose difference is 8. You have to find two integers whose product should be minus 15 and whose difference is 8. So for two integers and their product should be minus, your integers should be both in negative sign. Okay. So we know that 15. For 15, you know that 5 into 3, that gives you 15. Clear now? So if we will multiply both, what we will get? Minus of 15. Okay. But if we will finding difference of both, what we will get? Minus 5. Minus minus will be plus. It will be minus 2. See here, you are getting minus 2. Okay, for minus 5 and minus 3. But if we will take minus 3 and minus 5, just reversing, okay? Minus 5, not 5 and 3, we are taking minus 3 and 5. What we will get? Minus 50. Sorry. Both will give you positive sign, okay? See here. So this will be 3. If we take minus 3 and 5, okay? So what we will get? Minus 15. Clear? And if we differentiate both, what we will get? 5 plus 3, that is 8. Okay, so our pair of integers is minus 3 and 5. Now, second one, find a pair of integers whose product is minus 36 and whose difference is 15. Okay, you have to find a pair of integers whose product is minus 36 and whose difference is 15. In this case also, one should be positive and one should be negative. So, for 36, let us take 12 and 3. Okay, we are taking 12 and 3. So, what we will get? Minus 12 into 3. You will get minus of 36. And for finding difference of this, minus 12 minus 3, you will get minus, not like this, do like this, 3 minus of minus 12, that will give you 3 plus 12, that is 15. Means our pair will be minus 12 and 3. Clear? Hope this is clear to all of you. You can take another pair also. So this was your exercise 1.3. Rest of the questions, it is for you. You can do by your own. Try to solve it. Another exercise we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you.